at home with our children. Praise the Lord. One thing I've seen in the Bible is that, especially mothers who are committed to the Lord, they are able to pass on that grace and the knowledge of God unto their children, than the pastors. So we saw Hannah. Hannah was able to train someone. Someone knew the Lord. When a woman is committed to God, that passes on to his children. But what happened to some of my children? Swing. Praise the Lord. And we can say this about, Timothy, about his mother and his grandmother. Paul testified for the faith in their life. So let us stop using the children as an excuse of not getting ourselves committed. Drag them to the meetings. Praise the Lord. One day, something will spark in their heart. Amen. So he opened doors of grace unto us. So go to the next one. Is it frozen up? Okay. So in my conclusion of the sermon, so where and love are common things in the Bible. We all the time want to talk about the love of God. But anytime we are thinking about the love of God, that love of God generates work in our hearts. Generate work in our hearts. And these two cannot be separated. God is love, but how did God show that he loves us? He demonstrated this through the work of his creation. If you look at the way God ordered his creation before we were born, it shows the amount of love he has for us. And then the work of salvation shows also the way that God, the good word of God himself does. And one of the things that is unique is that because when it's so important to God, Bible says he gives us power. So when the disciples were, Jesus died, he said, wait until you receive what? Power. What is power? Power is what? The ability to do work easily. Yeah? Power is work over time, isn't it? Yeah. Ability to do work what? Easily. So that's how important. So do things that the Holy Spirit, God actually sends the Holy Spirit to help us, is to do work and also to pray. So prayer is so important. So God said that we don't know how to pray. So the Holy Spirit comes to help us with groans that word the Lord express. So I want us to understand things that are important to God. And if your father has something that is important and he cherishes, then you must also cherish it as well. We must also cherish it as well. Amen.
Amen.
You see, it is not something that we have to do. So he works as both to will and to act. So the only thing that we have to do is to avail ourselves. Who's ready to avail himself today for God to use, for good works? Good works in the home, the chores, at home. You see, when your mother says you go and do chores, that quotation should come to your mind since I was a child. What quotation should that be? You come to school, you are tired and all those things. Your schoolmate tells me I don't do chores. Your mother is so troublesome. What quotation should come to your mind? Angela, I'm looking at you. Honor your father and your mother. Praise the Lord. So if that quotation doesn't come to your mind, it does come to your mind. So if you disobey your parents, who are you disobeying? Who are you disobeying? Were you following my question? God. Why are you hesitating to say God? Because
your father and your mother.
They thought that they are off, isn't it? Praise the Lord.